So will the silver tsunami lead to housing prices crashing? According to Meredith Whitney of the Meredith Whitney Group, she's an analyst. She's saying that essentially baby boomers, people in their 50s, are going to start to sell their homes really soon in 2024. Now, this group represents, I think they own about 70% of the homes in America, 70%. And pretty soon they're going to start to sell their homes and they're going to downsize, and this is going to open up a lot of supply in the marketplace. And she's calling it the silver tsunami. My question is, if this happens, you have a bunch of people in their 50s downsizing to smaller houses and stuff, what's going to happen to the millennials? Because they're still struggling right now. And are they going to have enough money to buy these houses? Who's going to end up buying these bigger houses? Because of people in their 50s, they're at their peak earnings, right? They're close to their peak earnings. So they have much bigger houses than everybody else. The younger people. So if they start to sell their homes and they downsize, they're going to be buying the smaller homes. What type of homes are going to be on the market for the millennials? I mean, are they going to be able to actually afford these houses, these big houses that the 50-somethings are actually selling? I mean, that's just my question right off the bat. So we're going to look at possibly an increase in supply for houses, but what's happening right now in the market is, for years, you have companies like BlackRock coming in and buying up places, and they're treating these homes like they're investments in the sense that they buy it up and they're hoping that they can sell it for an even higher price. The problem is with the cost of living crisis, if you don't have enough regular people able to go into these homes and rent them out or buy them out, then, you know, are you really pouring a lot of money into something that's going to really act as a strong investment? I mean, that's the question. So what do you think? Because a lot of these 50-somethings, these baby boomers, they're going to end up buying these smaller houses in cash. So the millennials, they're not going to be able to really compete with them if that happens. You got this 50-something-year-old or 60-year-old coming in willing to buy a house for cash. What's going to happen with those two 20-something-year-olds trying to start a family? I mean, where are they going to end up? Are they going to be forced into a situation where they're going to have to rent for the rest of their lives? Not everybody really wants that. Anyway, Ukraine. Okay, Ukraine. Zelensky versus Zelensky. Well, basically the commander of the armed forces, the number two guy in charge. Zelensky, of course, is the president, and there's talk from the defense minister to sort of push, to sort of have this this commander of the armed forces removed, dismissed. This commander of the armed forces could be possibly pushing for a coup. His right-hand man was recently killed in a really bizarre hand grenade situation. This is political collapse in Ukraine. It's this reality. It's the end of the road, and it's pretty obvious for a lot of people. I wonder if Zelensky is going to leave the country. I don't know how it's going to end, but politically, they can't win this war. It's just becoming obvious to a lot of people outside the country. So we'll see what happens as far as Ukraine. The focus is very much on Israel at this point. Okay, right here in the U.S., Youngkins. Clearly, he's not going to be the Republican Party's, the RNC's savior. His Republican Party in Virginia didn't do well at all in the last night's elections. Virginia wasn't a good story for them. It's a blue state. I viewed it as a blue state for a while. In Ohio, they had an abortion measure that didn't really work out for the Republicans. And in Kentucky, they lost, the Republicans lost the governor's race. So Andy Beshard was reelected Democrat in a deep red state. Not a big surprise. I mean, honestly, I didn't take the candidate Cameron very seriously at all. Excuse me. At this point, it seems like the Republican Party is just really there. The RNC is just really there to make sure the conservative movement doesn't get off the ground, doesn't really impact American life, because it just seems like they have a culture of losing. And now people are calling for a ban. C. Bannon's calling for, the replacement. Well, a number of people in the Republican Party is calling for the replacement of the chairwoman of the RNC. She's a Romney. She's McDaniels. Ronnie McDaniels. She's a Romney, related to the Romneys. She's part of that family. And here's the deal. It seems like, why are the Romney Republicans in the driver's seat in a political party that's pretty much MAGA. Now, there's a big disconnect even within the Democratic Party and the Republican Party between the voters and the leadership, because the leadership, they're not representing the best interests of the people in their respective parties. I wonder if they just exist to really just sabotage any type of progress. I wonder if that's the reason why they're there. Let's talk about removing this lady. Anyway, guys, just want to give you guys a quick little update on some of the things that are going on, some of the things I thought was really interesting. Question of the day: what do you think is going to happen as far as housing? And will young people ever be able to get on their feet in the housing market in America? And will that be delayed? And if so, for how long? Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. And don't forget, the future belongs to those who prepare for it today.